What's going on, everyone? So Miami did it again, losing the first play-in game, winning the second, end up getting to be the eighth seed. We'll see if they can have another historic run. I mean, they beat the brakes off of Chicago. Like, Chicago had no chance. They had like 68 points at like the 8 minute mark of the fourth. Like, it was bad. Really bad. I thought it would be a little closer, a little better of a game, especially with no Jimmy Butler. But man, like, Miami just ran through them. And it sucks because, like, I really wanted, and I've said this in previous videos, I said it on As It Stands Sports, which if you're not subscribed to As It Stands Sports, go subscribe to As It Stands Sports. I should probably promote that more. But nonetheless, right, like, you have Boston, who I think Boston, for the most part, should just run through everybody in the East. I mean, there's a couple teams, like Milwaukee's had some success against them, but I think ultimately Boston's just the superior team in the West. But I really wanted Miami, like healthy Miami, to play Boston, because a healthy Miami playing Boston, I don't know if they win, but I believe they would at least test them. And I want to see, like, what does Boston look like tested? What does Boston look like? Do they crumble? Do they just fall apart, right? Do they lack that mental toughness? Because, you know, Marcus Smart was like their one tough mental guy. He was the guy that was rallying the troops. He was the leader in the locker room, all that stuff. And he got rid of him. So it's like, who is it going to be? Is it going to be Drew? Is it going to be Jason and Jalen? That's kind of the idea. That's why they kind of moved off that. Kind of, here you go. This is their team. Like, they should be the leaders. Right? Did Jason Tatum just completely disappear in big games, big moments, right? Like, I think Miami would just have hounded them and made things very interesting, which, you know, from a Lakers standpoint, there's 2 points, and we're going to dive into the Lakers side of this here in a moment. But one thing is, like, you know, if Miami ends up beating Boston and the Lakers end up beating Denver, I think they win the championship, because I think they run through whoever they play in the East. They just have to get through the gauntlet that is the West. And then anybody outside of Boston, I think the Lakers just dominate. I mean, we beat Milwaukee twice without, like, LeBron and stuff. Like, we'd be good there. Boston, I know people look at it as like, oh, we beat Boston without LeBron and AD. But I think that was a lot of Boston. I mean, they shot like 43 threes and only shot like 30%. Like, they basically shot themselves out of the game, instead of like what you saw with Houston and San Antonio, where they just were aggressive and attacked the basket. But, right, like, I just want to see what Boston looks like tested. And also, if we play them, right, then we have an idea of, like, okay, well, if we can just put pressure on them, they might crumble, right? Like, where if you see Miami and it's like, oh man, this really is a different Boston team, right? If they just, like, kind of beat Miami in five or something, right? So I think it would have been a good indicator for the Lakers. But more than anything, Chicago losing, I think, is going to make very interesting. Atlanta lost, and you're already seeing the abundance of trade rumors, right? Oh, you know, all the media heads are all, you know, Atlanta lost, Chicago lost, but the Lakers won, right? Like, Lakers got the victory because Trae Young and DeJounte Murray, one of them will be a Laker. And, like, look, I wouldn't mind DeJounte Murray, especially because if you get DeJounte, you can get other pieces, right? Like, whether it's from Atlanta or it's from other things, where if you get Trae, that's basically it. You're trading for Trae and you're done. But there's a lot of talk about the Lakers acquiring Trae. I mean, there have been talks for years, but this last, like, you know, a couple months has really ramped up about Trae to the Lakers. Even Kendrick Perkins talked about, like, oh, I know who's going to the Lakers and it's going to be great for AD. And everyone was like, okay, so it's Trae Young. Like, just say Trae, right? Like, and then, I mean, but the Trae to the Lakers thing date back to, like, his draft day, right? Like, he wanted to be a Laker. He always was hoping to, like, find a way to get to the Lakers. So this may be his opportunity. And look, I know Trae recently, because I'm sure somebody will mention it, Trae recently said, you know, he wants to stay in Atlanta and stuff like that. You hear every player right before they get traded say that, right? I mean, Dame talked about it, everybody, right? I mean, DeMar DeRozan is a great example. Organizations talk about it. You hear it all the time. We know Atlanta needs to break up one of the two, whichever of the two. Again, I'm not big on Trae. I'm not personally. If he comes, I'll be happy. I'll support it. Let's figure it out. Because on paper, if it works, watch out. Good luck beating the Lakers, right? LeBron James, Trae Young, and Anthony Davis, plus whatever, you know, filler you have around it. If you can keep a Jared Vanderbilt, got Vando. Mel, you just go get a 3-and-D guy for the two guard, right? And now you're winning a championship. But I also worry about the fit and stuff. But I've talked about Atlanta in a previous video. Go check out that if you want more in-depth on Atlanta. I want to talk about Chicago, because Chicago is in a very interesting situation. Now, again, DeMar DeRozan has talked about he wants to re-sign. Chicago has talked about how they want to re-sign DeMar DeRozan. You hear it all the time. DeMar was in Toronto, and they swore up and down that they weren't going to trade him, and he swore he was going to... Guess what? He got traded. San Antonio, he wanted to stay in San Antonio. Guess what? He ends up going to Chicago. So, DeMar DeRozan's a free agent. He's only getting older, so... How much longer is he going to be willing to just kind of play without winning a championship or being in contention, right? Unless he doesn't care. I mean, not all players care, but he's always struck me as a guy that does want to win, and he does value winning, and he has talked about value winning. So to me, the issue is you wouldn't be able to just sign DeMar DeRozan because he's not going to take a vet minimum deal, or he's not going to take the, you know, taxpayer mid-level, which is like $6 million. He's not doing something like that. He's still very good, right? So... you probably have to work out a sign and trade, but that's fine, right? Like, honestly, and like, this isn't as good long-term, right? Trey makes sense because of the long-term, because he's like 25. So like, you even have him after Anthony Davis's new contract. So even when Anthony Davis's contract expires, you still have Trey Young to kind of still build around. He'll only be like 29 at that point, right? So he'll still be under 30 or right around 30 by the time AD's contract expires. So, right, the idea is the upside. You got a 20-year-old star who, you know, hopefully has a little bit of upside, and you're off to the races. That's the idea. And then when LeBron leaves, you got Trey and Anthony Davis to build around. Again, that's the idea. But for like the next like 2-3 years, I don't hate the idea. Like, go get me DeMar DeRozan, Alex Caruso, and Andre Drummond, right? Like, can we work out some sign and trade deal, work out something to where, you know, we can get DeMar and Caruso, right? Because to me, I would rather that. Like, let's say we lose D'Lo, right? Then, like, you could just, because Alex Caruso and DeMar DeRozan can initiate the offense, and everything's going to run through LeBron anyway, like we see. So, like, you could just go, like, DeMar, Caruso, Vando, or you'd still have money and assets and stuff like that, because you're not going to have to trade 3 firsts and all this stuff to go get those guys, right? So now, like, if Chicago decides to blow it up, go get me those two guys, and then go get, like, a legit 3-and-D guy, right? Like, can you convince, like, KCP to come? Like, that would be great, right? Like, and then you could go, like, imagine, like, DeMar, KCP, Caruso, LeBron, and AD. Like, I think that that's... I think you're talking championship, and you'd still have enough assets and whatever else you need to go round out the bench. And because DeMar, like, let's say he's making $20 million a year. Now, you would be hard capped because of the sign and trade, but that's fine, right? Like, you'd have like DeMar on $20 million, LeBron James and Anthony Davis be your only max guys. Alex Caruso's making like $10 million. If you can go get KCP for like, you know, $11, $12 million, something like that, if he does decide to leave. Otherwise, go get like a Royce O'Neal or something like that. Or go work out a sign and trade. Maybe go get like a Valanciunas or something, right? Can you work out some deal where you get Val? And then you could even just go big. Go like DeMar, Caruso, LeBron, AD, and Val, right? Like, there's, you have so many options and flexibility. But the reason, again, that this was important is because Atlanta and Chicago are the two teams that have been heavily linked to the Lakers that the Lakers are heavily going to pursue. There's also Zach LaVine. Now, look, I have been in the camp of Zach LaVine, but also circumstances have changed, and we'll see what happens in the offseason. Like, to me, Zach LaVine was, like, the best option at the time, if healthy, right? And the upside and the potential, and it was like, okay, well, we have to trade all these things, right? Like, I was team DeMar DeRozan before anything, right? Like, if you go back and look at the videos, right, I was DeMar, go get DeMar, go get DeMar, go get DeMar, for, like, months. And then when DeMar finally was off the table and everything was done, I was like, okay, well then Zach LaVine gives you more upside, right? But then ultimately he ends up getting surgery. Now, how much of that was because he was probably going to Detroit and he was like, I'm not going to Detroit, right? Like, there's a lot of that kind of speculation, which I do think is kind of odd, right? Like, he's perfectly fine. He's supposed to come back and be healthy. He's supposed to play basketball. And then the Detroit rumors start, and he's like, I'm going to go get surgery, right? Like, it just seemed a little odd. But to me, like, how good is he? Again, I'm still team, go get DeMar, go get Alex Caruso, go get these various guys, right? Can you work something out like that? So this offseason is going to be very interesting. And I know some people are going to look like, hey, this is offseason talk, this and that. But it's relevant right now because these two teams just got eliminated. So it is still a talking point. It is still worth having the discussion. I'm not going to start making a bunch of videos about it. We'll do that when we get to the offseason. We'll break down all the rumors, all the talks. If you've been familiar with this channel the last two offseasons, you know what it does. We go over and give our opinions and thoughts on everything. So we'll have all the offseason talk when the offseason comes. Lakers got to go win a championship right now. But this is relevant because, again, Chicago just took an L. And so now we can kind of see how that goes and along with Atlanta. And this, of course, is going to be rumors and talks and all that stuff. But anyway, as always, this is a discussion. Pass a question on you. Let me know your thoughts and opinions down in the comments below. What do you think? First off, what are your thoughts on these play-ins? Obviously, the Pelicans and Sacramento got to play. I might do a video talking about that after. But yeah, again, love your thoughts, opinions, how you feel. Let me know down in the comments below. That being said, if you haven't liked this video, hit that like button. Helps me a lot so you enjoy these types of videos, and I truly appreciate it. Not subscribe to the channel, hit that subscribe button. Turn on the bell notifications. Appreciate y'all. See you in the next one. Thank you.